Hi there, today on Typical Books, it'll be my top 5 extreme horror. Now, of course, this is my top 5 extreme horror, so it's up for debate, really, honestly. And this is one of those weird subgenres of horror where there are a lot of opinions and opinions run wild. And it is like, does Bizarro fit in? Is it all splatterpunk? Does it need to be splatterpunk? Are there things that are too far for even extreme horror fans? Or is nothing off the table? Of course, I have a big affinity for like serial killers and slashers or madness and psychosis, not so much supernatural. Now, the supernatural debate happens within extreme horror as well. Are there many supernatural titles within extreme horror? Well, let's see. Number 5 was hinted at before, and there's some wild cards within this list too, okay? So this one is a short story by Stephen King called Survivor Type. And you may be asking, you know, how can a 70s old ass story by Stephen King of all people, grandpa horror, be in among your extreme picks? Well, I'd say read Survivor Type. Or if you want, you can head over to Shudder and check out the most recent Creepshow iteration that is animated that has a story by Joe Hill and a story by Stephen King. And this one in particular is harrowing. Survivor Type in particular gave me nightmares. It made me wonder how would this be adapted to screen, even at a young age. It made me wonder what goes on in the mind of this man. More than any other Stephen King story, because a lot of people do, I guess, reportedly wonder that about horror writers. I wondered that about Stephen King at that moment, and that story has haunted me. I think about it all of the time. Well, not all of the time, but a lot of the time. And I've thought about it year after year after year. It's to see it adapted for screen in any way, shape, or form was fantastic. The story itself, to read it again, is still harrowing, and it talks about a lot of things that we find extreme. The thoughts, the madness, drug use, and auto-cannibalism, having to, you know, sawing the foot off in Saw. That small scene has got nothing on Survivor Type. So if you haven't read it, I definitely recommend picking up Survivor Type, finding it somewhere, watching the adaptation of it, the animation. Survivor Type is number 5 on my extreme list. I'd have to say that it really holds that position as being the first extreme thing I ever read, and it left me wanting more. Flash forward to way later in my life, and Jack Ketchum makes an appearance. This is number 4, Offspring, and you could lump in a lot of other Jack Ketchum. It depends on what it is that you count as extreme. The Girl Next Door is most definitely extreme horror, and a lot of these have to do with things like cannibalism, insanity, and mutations, or just the cruelty. It's really the cruelty, I think, that really sums up extreme horror for me, and you'll find that as a thread going forward in a few of these books that I talk about. Anything by Jack Ketchum really is a study on cruelty, and I have a theory, of course, that he takes a lot of true crime stories and turns them into books. Like even Red, it seemed, had a hint of a true crime story in there. I don't know so much with Offspring though. So before you think that it has to be not supernatural and maybe cannibals and true cruelty to be extreme horror, I will say enter my 3rd pick. Here we are at number 3 with Edward Lee, The Haunter of the Threshold. This is his take on some H.P. Lovecraft, and he's also got some more H.P., if you like, in Lucifer's Lottery. And his whole house, Infernal City, Infernal, that trilogy is fantastic and supernatural and delves into hell and is so crude and extreme. And it's sort of edging on Bizarro with the humor too. Like, I'm not the biggest Bizarro fan, and it is where that crossover between Bizarro and extreme is where I really do like to hang out, edging more into the extreme. Edward Lee definitely dances that line really well. Then you get, you know, that cannibalistic, savage cruelty in things like Heder. Very famous for Heder he was. And I really like his novel The Black Train, popularized in the United Kingdom under the title Gast. This is The Black Train. It is not necessarily as extreme as most of Edward Lee's things, and nowhere near extreme as the books I'm talking about here today, but it does deal with some heavy duty themes. Urination, urophilia, I suppose it would be. Golden showers, as it were. Some pregnancy related things, and cessation of pregnancy related things. So it's not as extreme as the other books, but it is a wonderful story, and I really enjoyed it very much. I found it extremely dark, and he writes cruel women extremely well, and it has none of the Bizarro humor nor the hellscape of his other books. It's the most rooted, I think, in the real world. So if you like real, fairly realistic horror, and it's somewhat historical horror here too, then this may be for you. It is quite intense, I will say. Now, there are a lot of really insane themes. That's the one thing that hasn't really been that I've mentioned. You know, in the survivor type, we have some very one person against themselves insanity going on. And it is brutal due to the gross out, as Stephen King would say, and the brutality of it all, and the viscera, and the descriptions of that viscera, and that sort of thing is what's hard to keep reading. With the Jack Ketchum stuff, there is a lot of rape and cruelty and domination. It's very, very well written that way, and it's harrowing. We get a lot of all of that with Edward Lee, and he writes some really degrading stuff. And it's very scatological, urology, all of these horrible, messy, gross, dirty, squishy, squelchy things, alongside, you know, full-on decapitations and crazy things with the dead human bodies, like all sorts of insanity is going on there. And I would hesitate to say that there's necessarily violence against women. He has violence against everything, violence against everybody. There's violence equally distributed amongst men and women, and it is all horrible and vile, rotten and grotesque. I really love Edward Lee. He is the king of splatterpunk in so many ways. Now, it's a real toss-up for position number two between Rath James White. It's The Resurrectionist is the Rath James White book that I have that ties number two with Ryan Harding. And Ryan Harding's Genital Grinder, just a beautiful study in depravity. And there's some very dark places here having to do with the sex trade and underground porn, snuff films, and just some very crazy backwoods insanity going on with a degrading, depraved death. And I really enjoy Ryan Harding's style. And I think that there's like a new wave of the splatterpunk, or people trying to keep splatterpunk undead. And he really is one of my favorites as far as the newer crop. And not to say totally new, he has a lot of work out up there with Edward Lee and Jack Ketchum and all of the other big names as far as extreme horror go. And this does not delve into bizarro necessarily. It is straight up horror. There's no supernatural really leanings in this particular collection. It's a very short collection, and you'll notice this is from Deadite Press. If you're interested in extreme horror and want to get into that bizarro, not so much the supernatural usually, just depraved human on human insanity, Deadite Press is really the place to go. A lot of Harding and Rath to be found there. Like Rath James White, the person, not Rath the feeling. But there is wrath, all kinds of wrath. And number one, extreme. Thank you, Garth Ennis. I've never read anything quite as insane as Crossed. The first editions and some of the books that we have here. This is Crossed Psychopath, still in the plastic, so it's all shiny. I took these out of their boards just for this. But we've got quite a bit of Crossed hanging out in this house. Crossed is something that blew my mind. Way back when I read Survivor Type, I didn't think I could really read something quite as insane. And then later on, I discovered Jack Ketchum and thought, oh my, that has been breached. I've never read something quite as insane. And then I started reading further into some Edward Lee territory. And you could say, you know, into layman territory as well. I thought, oh wow, I've never felt like I've read something so dangerous. And then I discovered some of the newer splatterpunks. And Rath James White came onto my radar, and Ryan Harding, of course. And I thought, oh my God, I've reached the zenith of insanity on paper. And then I read Crossed. A friend of mine that worked at a bookstore was surprised they had Crossed. And when he saw it there, he said, oh my gosh, you've got to read this. It took me a little bit to get around to it. But I could understand why he was surprised that it was allowed in the bookstore. And you can find it in the bookstore. I've picked up quite a bit of Crossed at Black Squirrel Books here in Ottawa. And you can order it, of course, like a normal book. All of these books are not taboo. They are not on the list of banned materials by any means. They are viable literature in every way, shape, or form. And this is a viable art. I'd say Crossed is some of the most beautiful and depraved and fantastical and insane and grotesque horror I've seen on paper, maybe since Hellraiser. Hellraiser was very beautiful looking comics, and these are very beautiful as well. But if you like Zero Day Zombie insanity and things like Hater by David Moody that I was talking about last video, my last tag video, reminded me quite a bit of Crossed. And Crossed is like that to the nth degree, with some really just insane near supernatural depravity going on in Crossed. So I really do recommend it, especially if you like short form insanity and really good artwork. You know, definitely look up Crossed. It is a really good addition, and it kind of goes face to face with survivor type as far as short, sharp, insane, little tiny grotesque horror. And you have that trajectory, for me anyway, from survivor type, just its mind-bending, relentless gore, to something like Crossed, which is just balls out insanity. So there you have it, my five top extreme, with sort of a tie between Rath, James White, and Ryan Harding. I hope you enjoyed that. If you've read a lot of these authors, let me know. If there is some extreme horror out there that I'm missing entirely, then let me know in the comments below, and have a nooky spooky day.